It's well known government science projects can be quite mysterious and sometimes even shady. So whenever it's possible to get a peek behind the curtains, incredibly interesting information can come out. Thanks to document releases, we actually get to see some of these projects. So on This Sci-Fi, we go over 5 fascinating secret government science projects. Number 5, Project 1794. This project, declassified in 2012, may be an explanation for at least some UFO sightings, provided it was never really cancelled, as this is hard proof that Canada and the United States have had close interest in flying saucers. The documents released by the United States Air Force contain the plans for a flying saucer-type aircraft. The purpose of this aircraft was supposedly to shoot down Soviet bombers, though it never reached that point. The saucer, referred to as the Avrocar, was developed for the United States by Avro-Canada. It was developed around the Kwando effect, which meant it was supposed to provide lift and thrust from a single turburator, blowing exhaust out of the disc's rim. The plans showed that they were targeting a speed of Mach 4, which means 4 times faster than the speed of sound. They also wanted it to reach an altitude of 100,000 feet. These results would have been game-changing and could possibly have even altered air travel as we know it today. However, the design proved to have more issues than it could compensate for. The original design resulted in the vehicle's inability to hover above ground effect. Ground effect is the buoyancy created by the cushion of air below the vehicle. After this first test, changes were made and many more models were tested. In one test, the Avrocar became unstable as soon as it went airborne and the 3 wheels went down and dug into the ground. Another saw the craft go airborne, but at the cost of severe instability and staying horizontal. On November 12, 1959, the car was tested for the first time free of restraints. The test highlighted major issues in the design, and on December 5th, the project was halted. Over that winter, a completely new design was proposed, and the saucer went back to the testing ground. After testing a modification, this version also failed to see reliability. A NASA flight evaluation saw the Avrocar reach 20 knots, which is 37 kilometers an hour or 23 miles per hour, and cross a ditch about 6 feet long and 45 centimeters or 18 inches deep. This lackluster result was also accompanied by many other mechanical issues. In March of 1961, funding ran out. Soon after, in December of that year, the Avrocar and related programs were cancelled. In 2002, a full-scale replica of the Avrocar was built for a movie and is now currently on display in a museum in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Number 4. Project Iceworm. Back in the 60s, the US Army had created a plan to build a series of mobile nuclear missile launch sites hidden under Greenland's ice sheet. The intention was to keep mid-range missiles close enough to hit targets in the Soviet Union. They created a cover research project called Camp Century. In 1960, engineers were sent 150 miles north from the already in use Thule Air Base to begin testing. Now, Camp Century was no secret from the world. It was not only approved by the Danish government, but also profiled in the Saturday Evening Post magazine. The public was told the research was meant to test construction techniques under Arctic conditions, also the use of semi-mobile nuclear reactors and other ice cap science experiments. In reality, they were trying to build a system of tunnels 4,000 kilometers or 2,500 miles in length to deploy up to 600 nuclear missiles in case of nuclear war. A total of just under 3.2 kilometers or 2 miles of tunnels were built. The tunnels contained a hospital, a shop, a theater, a church, and housed around 200 people. The electricity came from the world's first portable nuclear reactor, and water came from melting glaciers. After only 3 years, scientists discovered that the glaciers were moving at a much faster pace than they anticipated. For safety reasons, the project was abandoned. By 1965, the tunnels were evacuated and the nuclear generator was removed. By 1966, the project was officially cancelled and the base was closed for good. Some more recent studies show some dangers from the site. When the project ended, the infrastructure and waste was left behind under the assumption that they would be covered in snow more and more as years went on. They did not, however, account for climate change. If trends continue as they're going, the site could be completely uncovered by 2100, and the biological, chemical, and radioactive waste will pose a threat to nearby ecosystems. Number 3. Acoustic Kitty. If you're no advocate for animal testing, this project may disturb you, and if you are, this might change your mind. This again comes from the depths of the Cold War. Acoustic Kitty was a project from the CIA as an attempt to turn house cats into spies for the United States. The cats were meant to spy in the Kremlin and Soviet embassies, after a few surgical enhancements, that is. Scientists implanted a microphone inside the cat subject's ear, a small radio transmitter at the base of its skull, a thin wire in its fur, and a tail-based antenna. The equipment inside the cat, however, did not change the natural tendencies, and things like hunger and curiosity had to be addressed. The first cat was used for a mission to spy on 2 men talking in a park. Unfortunately, once the cat was released, it ran onto the road and was immediately struck and killed by a passing taxi. A second cat was then brought in. Surprisingly, the technology itself was not the issue. Again, trying to get the cat to behave and act as it was intended to was incredibly difficult. The training of the animal failed, and the equipment was removed from the cat. This one apparently went on to live a long and healthy life. Other attempts were made with other cats, but the same problem prevailed. The cats were impossible to train. In 1967, the project was cancelled, and in 2001, released to the public. Acoustic Kitty apparently cost the US government about $20 million. Regardless, the moral of the story is, if you ever fear your pets are watching you, it's not impossible. Number 2. Operation Morning Light. This is less of an experiment and more of a covered-up experiment gone wrong. In September of 1977, the Soviet Union launched the nuclear-powered spy satellite Cosmos 954. This satellite weighed over 4 tons and was 46 feet in length. Only a few months after the launch, scientists came to the conclusion Cosmos 954 was slowly falling out of orbit, and unless the Soviet Union could regain control, it would inevitably plummet down to Earth's surface somewhere near North America. The American government pressured the Russians to declare all that was on board the satellite. It turns out, the satellite was carrying 110 pounds of highly enriched uranium. After the information was divulged, the CIA directed the government not to tell the public of the potential disaster, under the reasoning that it would disturb people in unforeseeable ways. By 1978, the United States had a team trained to respond to emergencies of this kind. This team, called NEST, or the Nuclear Emergency Search Team, waited for the destination of the satellite landing to be determined, as no one actually knew where it would be in the continent. After becoming increasingly worried about the occurrence of a catastrophe, the National Security Advisor disclosed to America that they were currently experiencing a space-age difficulty. Fortunately, this catastrophe was avoided when the satellite crashed down in the depths of the Canadian tundra. No one was injured. The NEST team dispatched in vans disguised as bakery vans, and the scene was cleaned over the course of several months. 90% of the radioactive debris that covered over a 50 by 800 mile corridor was recovered. Officials later found out that if Cosmos 954 had orbited the Earth only once more before it went down, it would have landed somewhere over the densely populated American East Coast. And number 1. NERVA or Kiwi. Long before the current Mars mission, and before Elon Musk sent his Tesla to the Red Planet, NASA and AEC scientists were working on a Mars trip on a nuclear-powered rocket. Area 51's lesser-known sister site, Area 25, was home to the project called NERVA, short for Nuclear Engine Rocket Vehicle Application. The rocket ship built was named Orion and stood 16 stories tall. It was supposed to send 150 men to Mars in the short time span of only 124 days. When under testing, the rocket reached temperatures of 3,680 degrees Fahrenheit, or 226 degrees Celsius, and had to be cooled by liquid hydrogen gas and bolted down to the Earth. The engine would also shoot a plume of hydrogen exhaust that had first passed through a superheated uranium fissure reactor. The scientists then became curious what would happen if they hadn't taken these precautions, and they lost control of the engines and it exploded. This is where they got the idea to intentionally blow up an engine. On January 12, 1965, the nuclear rocket engine, codenamed Kiwi, was purposely overheated to the point of explosion. The result shot a colorful display of radioactive fuel into the sky above, and a 100-pound chunk of fuel landed a quarter mile away. The highly radioactive plume rose to about 2,600 feet, where passing winds carried it over LA and then out to sea. Scientists were waiting in the air to collect the amount of radiation that was released into the atmosphere. However, these data are still classified. Although this project was allowed because it was technically a safety test, it released so much radiation into the atmosphere that there is speculation it violated the Limited Test Ban Treaty of 1963, which banned airborne explosions of atomic bombs. Through the testing, scientists discovered that if an engine as this did explode on the launch pad, anyone within 100 feet would die instantly from radiation exposure. Anyone within 400 feet would be exposed to such a high dose that it would potentially be fatal, and anyone within 1,000 feet would be overexposed. Thanks for watching This Sci-Fi. If you like this video, be sure to check out my last video, 5 Incredible Things That Happen to Your Body in Space. Also, like and subscribe for more videos on all things science and science fiction.